were showing the kids kind of a culmination of what they've been working on all season. We have two gardens. We have a fall garden and a spring garden. The spring garden actually starts in January with the planting of the onions, and they were checking that. They take a little bit longer to grow. The potatoes we put in on February 14th, Valentine's Day. It's a good way so that I can remember it. And we harvest them about 2 to 3 weeks before the end of school.
We planted some onions, tomatoes, potatoes, corn, broccoli, lettuce, and others. And right now we are checking if they're ready to harvest.
We learned how the energies from the sun go to the plants, and how the plants go to us, and then how this cycle keeps going.
We start with horticulture and the stuff such as the breakdown of the soil, the mineral content. We're talking about compost also and how that breaks down. We're talking about the environmental factors, the amount of rainfall. We're talking about the temperatures, when's the proper time to plant, when's not. There's all kinds of stuff from atmospheric conditions to just the food chain and the energy chain. And I try to incorporate as much as I can so that the kids can see it's not just one facet. It's got various sides to it, and they can learn and go, oh, I didn't know that.
We're learning about energy, how the sun produces energy for our plants, and it produces chemical energy, and when we eat it, it turns into mechanical energy, and when we wear it off, it turns into thermal energy.
I started at Lyles Middle School. I was there for 16 years and I had a garden. Then I came over here and I asked, can I have a garden? And I said, sure, and things have just kind of expanded.
Mr. Reyna's great. He's actually the best science teacher I've ever had. I love his class, and I just want to stay here forever.
What's so fun is that Mr. Reyna gets everybody interacted in it. He doesn't let somebody slack off or somebody not do something. He tells everybody to do it. He lets everybody join in. And if you're not participating, you find something for you to participate with.
It's better being hands-on. I mean, it's the best thing you could ever learn.
What's really cool is we'll get seniors that are coming back for scholarships that we award here at Schrade Middle School. And one of the things that they always seem to remember is the garden. They remember they planted and they ate my mashed potatoes, and every tree that was planted out here was planted by sixth graders. So they have a legacy tree. So they have this tie to the school, and hopefully some of this will transition into their home life. Just like one of my students, actually several of my students that have created gardens for the first time this year.